everyone. Welcome back to the Integrity Botanicals YouTube channel. Today I am doing part two of what's new for the month of October. And we got a ton more stuff, you guys. I feel like I can almost do a part three, but I am going to power through and keep it at part two. First and foremost, a very exciting new skincare drop on the website from Vintner's Daughter. This is the Active Treatment Essence with a pretty penny of $2.25 on this one, but hear me out. This thing does it all. So the main difference to the serum, because they do pair very well together, and here is why. All of the nutrients inside of here are water soluble, so it complements the serum beautifully. Of course, these two are meant to be used in combination for the absolute best of the best results. A lot of you already love the serum, and if you are looking to repurchase, if you do purchase it, you will get a free sample of the Active Treatment Essence. The sample looks a little something like this. Quite a generous size. It's what I have been using to get my feelings on this product, but the feelers are still out there, so I'm just going to run down the facts for now. This is a multi-correctional product, much like the serum as well, so this is meant to brighten, smooth, heal, calm, balance, hydrate, firm the skin, all of that good stuff. And some of the key nutrients that help it do so are vitamin C, hyaluronic acid, pre and probiotics, marine microalgae, as well as exfoliating acids. There are a ton more. I'm going to include the full ingredients list down below. I just wanted to kind of run down this product for you guys, but I did want to also make sure I made a quick note on the apple cider vinegar that is listed in this product. It also gives it a smell as well. It's not as strong as potent, fresh out the bottle apple cider vinegar, so don't let that off put you, but there will be a little vinegary note that you pick up on this product for sure. And I did want to let you guys know that apple cider vinegar was not added directly into this product. Essentially, they do a, it's like the mother of apple cider vinegar through their phytonutrient infusion process. So essentially that's like the strong bacterial portion that has all the good stuff that we love about apple cider vinegar in there. And that is basically what gives it its scent. And that is the portion of the apple cider vinegar that was used. It was not added directly to the product. So just a quick note on that, but I will have a full ingredients list down below as well as some other key notes so you guys can learn a little bit more about the product, because it is a spendy one, but what I've used of it so far, I think it is great, and I think Vintner's Daughter is a fantastic line, so I trust them very, very much, and look forward to continuing to try this product and bringing you guys my opinion in the future. A quick little tease, it's not out quite yet, but I did just want to put it out there that I'm wearing a new brow product. It might be in my brows right now, it might be in my hand, I don't know, it might be from Plume, it might be a pencil, it might be refillable. But this is coming really, really soon, so I wanted to tease you guys a little bit with this one because it's what I'm wearing today. I'm going to include it in the description box down below. You got a little spoolie here on the end in all of the same shades as the pomade, which I was super excited about because they do great on the shades here. Refillable system, so you save a little bit of money once you run out, but I will talk about that more in detail, but just know something new from Plume is on the horizon. Probably my favorite new product in this little roundup is from Air Perez, and this is their Mango Lip Honeys, which are essentially their vegan glosses. We have four beautiful shades, as you can see here. We have Glaze, which is this clear, Pop, which is this more cool tone pink. We have the shade Chili, which is this beautiful shimmering nude that I do have on my lips today. And we also have the shade Crush, which is this Kiss of Berry that I wore in my RMS review video. If you guys caught that one, I will link it down below. But these are great, non-sticky. They describe them as an intense syrupy gloss with subtle color. And that's exactly what they are. I think that just sold to me, the name Mango Lip Honey Intense Syrupy Gloss. I was like, I'll take 10. And I really am into these shades. Formula so far, I am really enjoying. High shine finish, no stick at all. Really cool applicator, but I don't want to talk too much about them because I do think I want to do a dedicated video, show them on my lips for you guys, do a couple lip combos, something like that. But just know I am loving it and really excited about that from Air Perez. New from Lily Lolo, we have a new palette. This is their Enchanted Eye Palette. Very beautiful, a little bit of pops of color in here, a little bit more cool toned as well, which is not always my favorite, but if you guys want to see a review of this product, I will definitely bring that to you. This one seems to have a really nice setup, a lot of matte, metallic, a good little setup here with some fun color. So if you want a colorful tutorial, I will definitely bring that to you. But not only have they released this beautiful new fun one, they brought back my favorite of the Lily Lolo lineup, and that is the Pure Indulgence palette. More warm tone, more neutrals, kind of more my speed. You guys will remember this. I've reviewed it in the past, so I'll include that down below. They're $34, always a great price point from Lily Lolo. Formula isn't always the most right out the bat, very pigmented, but they blend well together. They're easy to use and to build up. So new from Lily Lolo there. They do also have 6 new lipsticks. I have 4 of them here, so I'm not going to swatch them all for you. I'm probably gonna do a dedicated video, but they have more of a shimmery finish. They all seem to have these more nude type names. Which one am I wearing today? Not Au Naturel. I think I'm wearing that's not it either. I am wearing the shade Undressed with that Air Perez gloss. So beautiful. I've reviewed the Lily Lolo lipstick formula in the past as well. They're a more buttery, but not sheer lip formula, more buildable, very, very comfortable to wear, very wearable, beautiful shade range. If you want to see the 6 new shades swatched, please do let me know. New from Fit Glow, we got an SPF from Fit Glow, and Fit Glow does the skincare makeup hybrid so well that it's a no-brainer that they released an SPF. You gotta have one. This is SPF 30. This is non-nano zinc oxide if you guys are concerned about that. It's a fragrance-free product. It's gluten-free. It's vegan. It sits well underneath makeup. It has a pump. I mean, what doesn't this thing have? Fit Glow is always the best. I've really been enjoying using this new SPF from them. I don't find it leaves a very strong white cast. It's really easy to blend in, and like I said, sits wonderfully under makeup. No fragrance at all, which I think is amazing, and an SPF of 30, like I said, which is perfect for everyday wear. Next up from Demamiel, you know I went wild for their spring oil, but now it is time for the autumn facial oil. I believe it was officially autumn on the 21st or 22nd of September, so this is ready to be used. The scent of this is much more musky. I'm getting really, really strong patchouli out of this, which isn't always my favorite scent, but it's not too powerful in this, which I love. It also doesn't linger on the skin if that's not a scent that you love. But we do also have prickly pear seed oil in here, which is great for hydrating the skin. White poppy seed oil, amaranth oil, carrot oil, jasmine oil. So I get a little bit of jasmine in here as well. The usual $130 price point from Demamiel. And I've actually never tried their autumn oil. I think I've only tried the summer and the spring in the past. And I have loved those so much. Been using this the past couple days, and I can say the same. Isn't too strong and oily for my more textured skin, or I also like to wear oils in the morning underneath my makeup. The Demamiel are some of the best under makeup oils that I have found. They sink in so beautifully, just make makeup look better, and this is no exception. So this is new. I don't know if I did a full dedicated video on Demamiel. I think I did more of like the ritual of applying it, because that's always the thing with Demamiel as well, especially with the focus on seasons and things like that. But I will have this product linked down below so you guys can check it out, because of course there are a ton of beautiful ingredients here that do a ton of beautiful things that I just cannot do it justice in this small little video. So more on that down below. All right, guys, we're getting there. I am powering through. The next up is from Amelie. Amelie has just been hot on the drops. I'm really excited for everything that they're bringing, because I love their face mist. That made me just fall in love with the line. And here we are. Now we've got some bio-fermented essences. Excuse me? Essences are really cool because they're between like a mist and a serum. So they're not like a just airy mist you can put all over your face, but they're not quite a serum. They have a little bit of a weight to them, but they're still very liquidy, if you know what I mean. I can't speak to the exact texture of these in particular. These are bio-fermented, so they're extra special. But I'm gonna throw up a quick image here. There are two. We have the Meadow Dew, and the Meadow Dew is more focused on the glow, the dew, the shine. So in both of these products, there is bio-fermented apple cider vinegar. Interestingly enough, because I just mentioned that in the essence of the Vintner's Daughter treatment essence. But this naturally nourishes and refreshes the skin. There's rose quartz and aloe vera in this one as well. So it's a good mix of these more calming properties, as well as just getting rid of all the dead skin and allowing the glow to sort of come through. Then we also have the Nocturnal Nectar, which also has the apple cider vinegar. But in here, we also have green tea, linden flower, snow algae. From what I've read about this product, it seems more designed for an anti-aging effect to the skin, which both are completely fascinating to me. I don't know which one I am more attracted to, but both of them are supposed to deepen the effects of the face mist, which I think is fantastic because, like I said, that's my number one most loved product. Always got one of those guys around in some form or another, but these will run you $86. I think they sound really unique. Amelie also does a very interesting blend of ingredients, so I will make sure to link both down below as always, so you can read a little bit more about it and see which one is for you, or let me know which one is piquing your interest a little bit more. I think the Meadow Dew is a little bit more my speed. So if you guys would like to see that, I will definitely try them and bring you some thoughts on some skincare products for sure. Now, I saved, I think, the best for last. It is just one heck of a drop. Vapor 2.0 is here, you guys. Say goodbye to the old Vapor, which had some products that I love, and don't worry, they are not all gone. It's mostly a rebranding as well as a launch of some new products. Some things have been reformulated, and when I do a full breakdown of that, I will make sure to tell you exactly what it is, because don't worry, I am going to be introducing Vapor 2.0 to you guys, doing individual reviews, the whole thing. I am so excited about it. But as a little tease, you can kind of see what the product's about. I do have one of their glosses here. I am waiting for a big old box of new stuff to arrive so I can play with it and soon bring you guys those reviews. But I think that they've really upped the packaging up a notch. I really like this cool mauve color. The Vapor logo looks beautiful. And this is, like I said, the Elixir Gloss. So I just quickly want to show you guys what the glosses are looking like so you can get an idea for the packaging. Very sleek. It is plastic, so it's not the heaviest or, you know, craziest thing ever. But I think it is a total aesthetic upgrade. I'm really, some of the new launch, they have eyeshadow palettes. So many exciting things. This applicator looks awesome. Ooh, yeah, that's a pretty color. I always like the Vapor glosses in the past, so I'm excited to try some potential new colors. You guys, there is so much on the website, and if you stalk the What's New section regularly, you will have seen it. So please sound off down below. What from Vapor do I possibly review first? I think I'm gonna do a little introduction first, and then we'll get into designated product reviews, but I always like to know what you guys are excited about. Have you tried any of it at all? Let your girl know, because I'm waiting on my package to arrive. I could not be more excited. But that is it, you guys. That is What's New, part two for the month of October. It was a doozy. Thank you for bearing with me. Everything you need to know, I always include in the description box down below. Helpful videos that I've done in the past, direct links to the product, a little bit more information, swatches, the whole thing is down below, so make sure you check it out. But most importantly, please do subscribe to this channel, because I upload here twice weekly, and I don't want you guys to miss it. Big thumbs up. You know, follow all of our social media that's down there always in case you miss me too much while I'm away. But always let me know what has piqued your interest. There is a lot to digest here. Make sure you catch part one. I will link that down below as well. But thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all the love and support. And I will catch you guys in my next one. Bye!